Hey, welcome to 12 Tone and happy Mother's Day. I thought it'd be fun to celebrate with a look at music's own tribute to maternity, the Mother Chord. As you can clearly see, this evokes a strong sense of... wait, what's going on? Okay, so it may not be the most maternal sounding chord you've ever heard, but it is actually called the Mother Chord. It's the first known solution to a sort of musical math puzzle, and since my mom loves math puzzles, it still feels pretty appropriate. So what's the challenge? Well, if you take a standard piano and ignore octaves, there are 12 unique notes. And there's 11 possible intervals between them. We could have a minor second, which is one half step, a major second, which is two, and so on up to 11 half steps, the major seventh. So the question is this, can we find a way to arrange our 12 unique notes such that we include each of those 11 intervals exactly once? We could try starting with this A, then go up 10 half steps to G, then 7 half steps to D, and then to C, which... whoops, that's 10 half steps again. Maybe this isn't so easy. Feel free to pause the video and try it out yourself. Actually, hold on. Okay, now pause. Got it? Alright, let's move on. This puzzle was both posed and solved by a composer named Fritz Klein, a student of Alban Berg. Berg is well known as a member of the famous circle of serialist composers known as the Second Viennese School. Klein's place in the history of serialism is a complex, messy story in its own right, but if you know your 20th century composition styles, you may have already figured out why he was asking this question. You see, serialism is built around a concept called a row, which is an arrangement of notes, usually all 12, which the composer plays around with in various limited ways in order to create an entire piece of music from a single line. So the goal here was to find what we might call an all-interval 12-tone row in order to create what Klein described as the boundary of chord-building possibilities. In effect, he claimed that if you could make a chord that had all the notes and all the intervals, it would have to be the most complex possible chord, and within the confines of our standard 12-note system, he's probably right. So how'd he find it? Well, it seems to be derived from another one of his inventions, the Pyramid Chord. Which is just all the intervals stacked from largest to smallest. The pyramid chord doesn't quite meet our needs though. For instance, it has two different G flats, here and here. It does have all the intervals though, so Klein figured it'd be a good starting place. From there, it seems to have been a matter of trial and error, playing with the order a bit at a time, until he realized that if he took all the repeated notes and lowered them each by a whole step, he'd get all his missing notes without losing any intervals. He called this new figure the Mother Chord because chord of 12 distinct tones and at the same time 12 distinct intervals seemed a little long. I'm not making that up, by the way. He actually said that in an article called The Boundary of the Semitonal World. You may have noticed, though, that he said 12 intervals, not 11. That's because in his original formulation, he included an extra note an octave below the lowest A in order to complete the collection, but he didn't count it as one of the actual tones. It's a bit of a cheat, and modern representations usually just leave that bit off. At this point, I'd like to take a moment to editorialize, if I may. Klein described the Mother Chord is uniting all chords within itself, and many modern accounts include claims about it containing every possible chord, and while this isn't wrong, it feels a little cheap to me. Yes, the Mother Chord contains all the chords because it contains all the notes that we make chords out of, but that's hardly a unique property. Klein's own work demonstrated that there are almost 500 million possible arrangements of the 12 notes, and each of those also contains every possible chord. Applying that description specifically to the Mother Chord, though, implies that it has something to do with the precise order the notes are in, or at least something to do with having all the intervals, and that's just not true. Now, I don't blame Klein for this. He was one of, if not the first person to systematically explore the concept of 12-note harmony, so over-attributing stuff to his pet chord is pretty understandable. I just wish we'd stop repeating it, because it sounds like it means a whole lot more than it actually does. Anyway, while it was the first solution to this problem, the Mother Chord isn't the only all-interval 12-tone row. There are 1,928 total possibilities, although for the sake of time, I won't go through them all. However, there are a couple standouts that have extra interesting properties, including one discovered by famed music theorist Nicola Mendoza. Mendoza is probably best known as the author of the Thesaurus of Scales and Melodic Ideas, which is exactly what it sounds like. In it, he describes another all-interval row that he dubs the Grandmother Chord. Now, what makes this interesting is the pattern of intervals. If we take these in pairs, we have 11 half-steps here, 9 here, 7 here, and so on. It's all the odd numbers arranged from largest to smallest. If we look at the gaps between the pairs, we see 2 half-steps, 4, 6, and you can probably figure out what's happening here. Slonimsky's managed to not only fit in all the notes and all the intervals, but do it in a fairly straightforward pattern, too. It's pretty beautiful, if you ask me. Another approach is to look for ones that contain additional mathematical structures within them, and the most notable of these are probably the link chords, named after theorist John Link. Link chords are a group of all interval rows that include something called the all trichord hexachord, which sounds scary, but it's actually pretty straightforward. A hexachord is a group of six notes, and a trichord is a group of three notes, so what we've got here is a collection of six notes that contains every possible arrangement of three notes inside it. Now, in order to make this work, we have to be a bit looser than we were before. Obviously, any group of six notes is going to be missing some, so we can't have literally every three-note combination. What we can have, though, is every three-note set. A musical set is a theoretical construct that can basically be boiled down to an interval pattern. For instance, this, this, and this are all different groups of notes, but they're also all major triads, and the major triad is always a root, a major third, and a perfect fifth, so for our purposes, they're the same thing. We could also include this, which is those same notes but in a different order, and this, which is the same intervals, just upside down. Once we strip all those away, we find that there exists exactly one six-note set that does what we want. This one. We can find the major triad here, the sus4 chord here, and so on. We can then take this hexachord and bury it within an all-interval row like this one to create a link chord, which is kind of like the musical math equivalent of a turducken, I guess. Anyway, what can we do with these chords? Well, as always, that's up to you. I think they're beautiful just as theoretical objects, but they're also great tools for exploring 12-tone serialism because they give you the maximum amount of choices in how to utilize your row. But most importantly of all, they make a great gift. Or something. Happy Mother's Day, y'all. And hey, thanks for watching and thanks to our Patreon patrons for supporting us and making these videos possible. If you want to help out and get some sweet perks like sneak peeks of upcoming episodes, there's a link to our Patreon on screen now. You can also join our mailing list to find out about new episodes, like, share, comment, subscribe, and above all, keep on rocking.